India's second locally made COVID vaccine may get EUA next month. India's current situation is heartbreaking to see. The country is literally being suffocated due to a severe shortage in oxygen supply, and it is only one reason why deaths have soared in cities. But help may come soon from another locally made vaccine now in phase 3 clinical trials. Created by Cadila Healthcare, or Cytos Cadila, the vaccine ZyCoV-D is now being tested in some 28,000 volunteers, including adults 75 years and older, and children between 12 and 18 years. Sharvil Patel, managing director, told CNBC, "We have completed the major recruitment for our phase 3 trial. ZyCoV-D is a DNA-based vaccine that uses plasmid DNA from bacterial cells. Its platform is innovative and rapidly developing just like the mRNA platform." According to the World Health Organization, DNA vaccines have several advantages over other platforms. First, it directly introduces a plasmid containing a DNA sequence to encode antigens in target tissues. These antigens are what will trigger an immune response. Second, DNA vaccines are believed to stimulate both B and T cell responses, which are necessary to effectively fight infection. And third, DNA vaccines do not require the infectious agent to induce an immune response. Meaning, no dead or weakened pathogen is necessary, removing the risk of infection. Other advantages include improved vaccine stability and relative ease to manufacture massively. However, the WHO warns that DNA vaccines must be carefully assessed based on the nature of the pathogen being immunized against. The efficacy data from the ZyCoV-D trials is expected to come out next month. After that, the company will seek emergency use authorization from the Indian drug regulator in May. Moreover, Patel said that the safety data is good in the ongoing phase 3 and previous trials, compared to most of the other vaccines that are there. Besides the DNA vaccine, Cadila is also working on a COVID-19 treatment. The experimental drug is called Virafin, an antiviral, and has shown clinical significance against patients with moderate COVID-19. This antiviral is administered subcutaneously or under the patient's skin, and just one dose is enough to improve the patient's condition. Though the drug should be given early during infection to avoid complications and ensure a speedy recovery. Based on the multicentric trial in 20 to 25 centers in India, the antiviral reduced the need for supplemental oxygen, which shows how it handles respiratory distress, a critical issue in treating COVID-19. Plus, the antiviral has been observed working against other viral infections.